In this video, we're going to focus on creating a testing pipeline. We're going to show how to set up a pipeline for, first of all, for unit tests, then for integration tests, and finally for live, or in this case, API tests, because they're going against a live API. Now, an important note here is that there are many ways to set up this kind of pipeline. This is not, definitely not the only way. It's a good way, but there are many plugins, there are many ways to configure them. So this is essentially one good way to set up a mature pipeline like this. All right, let's get started. So the first thing we care about is the name of the tests. So we're going to look at a few tests here. We're first of all going to look at some unit tests. So you'll immediately notice that the unit tests follow a certain naming convention. All of these end with unittest.java. Now let's also look at the integration test. And again, you'll notice the same kind of naming convention. All of these end with integration test.java, and of course, the live tests will all end with livetest.java. Now, the idea here is very simple. We want to make sure that we follow this strict naming convention, because we will make use of this naming convention using regular expressions then later on in Maven, and specifically in the Surefire plugin. So let's now start with the unit tests and the first step of this pipeline. So the unit tests are configured here in the main configuration of the Surefire plugin. We are basically excluding the integration tests, and we are also excluding live tests. So in this particular Surefire configuration, we are only running unit tests. Now you will also notice some system property variable configuration, and I do not use this right here because it's not needed, but you can definitely pass in property variables to your project if you need to. And this is just an example of that. It's just not in use. And there you have it. This is a very simple, very quick first step of the build pipeline. All right, so for the next step of the pipeline, which is the integration step, we're going to use profiles. So the first thing we need to do is we're gonna need to define a simple profile here, and we need to override the existing configuration for the Maven Surefire plugin. So we had the initial configuration, which was the configuration for the unit pipeline, and now we're defining another configuration, of course, very simple, for the integration pipeline. So we are, of course, excluding unit tests. These have already run as part of the previous step of the pipeline. And we are, of course, also excluding live tests, because this will be the next step of the pipeline. Right now, we only care about integration tests. Okay, so now let's actually run the first step of the pipeline and then this second step. We're going to first run the unit test pipeline, which would be just a clean install without any sort of a profile. And there we go. The pipeline ran, 12 tests ran, and let's see what these were. So all of these tests were unit tests. Unit test, another unit test. So you can clearly see how just the unit tests run in this first step of the testing pipeline. Let's now do the exact same thing, but let's run the integration profile. So we're going to be running integration. And there we go. The second step of the pipeline, the integration step, now ran. We have 89 tests running. We have one error. We are skipping one test. And the exceptions here in the logs are perfectly okay, because we are actually triggering some exceptions in these tests, so it's only natural to see those in the log. But you can immediately see that these are only integration tests that are running. So we are now at the third step of the pipeline, which is the live step. We now want to run all of the live tests against a live running deployed application. Okay, so this final step of the pipeline is, of course, a little bit more complicated than the first two. The first two we had very simple, very quick configuration, because nothing was supposed to be running while the pipelines were running. In this particular step, in the third step, we will need to actually start up a web server. We will need to start up a Tomcat server. And as you can immediately see here on the screen, we are starting up a Tomcat 8 server embedded, and we are running this over port 8081. Now, we won't go into the full detailed configuration of the cargo plugin. We will briefly discuss it, but this is beyond the scope of this particular video. So this is the default configuration of cargo, but now let's actually take a look at the live profile. Now, the first thing we need to do here is we need to wire in cargo to run in a certain phase of the Maven build. So what we are doing here, we are hooking up this execution and we are starting the server just before the integration testing phase, and then we are stopping the server right after the integration testing phase. So these are phases that allow us to do that in Maven, and we are basically just starting and stopping the Tomcat server with the deployed application. Okay, now with cargo out of the way, we need to look at the surefire configuration. So the first thing you'll notice here is that in the default configuration, we are overriding it and we are excluding everything. We need to exclude everything, and then we need to run these live tests only in a certain phase. We need to run these in the integration test phase so that they run after cargo starts up the Tomcat server and they run before cargo has a chance to shut down the Tomcat server. And the configuration here is specific for this particular execution for the integration test phase, and it's excluding integration tests, it's excluding unit tests, and it's only running live tests. So as you would expect, live tests now run in this integration test phase, and they have a chance to run when the Tomcat server is started and ready to accept requests. All right, so that was the configuration, and let's now actually run this final step and let's see how it behaves. Okay, so let's now take a look at what actually happened. So first thing you'll notice that actually no tests are running in the normal test phase, as is actually to be expected, because we are only running tests now in the integration test phase. And let's now see cargo. So cargo starts running here, it starts up the server correctly, and now live tests start running. So live tests now start running against this newly deployed application, and everything passes. Now, of course, there is going to be a lot of logging here. And there we go. We have 23 passing live tests all running against this deployed application. And then we have cargo actually shutting down the server. And that is it. We now have three steps in this testing pipeline. First, the unit tests, then the integration tests, and now the live tests, all running in separate profiles and all verifying another type of tests in the application. All right, hope you found this video useful. If you want to keep getting these quick tactical type of videos, go ahead and subscribe to the channel, and see you next time.